Well, it's game on. Former President Trump and Florida Governor Ron DeSantis are both touching down in Iowa this week, crisscrossing the Hawkeye State as the fight for the 2024 Republican presidential nomination kicks into high gear. Stephen Lawson is the former communications director for the DeSantis gubernatorial campaign, and Kevin Walling is a former Biden campaign surrogate. Thank you for being here, gentlemen. Thanks for joining us on Memorial Day. Let's go right to the fact that we have heard so much about Trump leading in the polls over DeSantis. But if you look at what we've got here to show you, the Des Moines Register poll on favorability, this is actually interesting. Looky there, for the very favorable rating, DeSantis 75%, Trump 80%. So they both, the Iowans like both of them. So let's start with you, Stephen. What do you say? What are we going to see?
Yeah, look, I think it's going to be an interesting primary. I think you're going to see Governor DeSantis just launch his campaign. I think he's going to bring energy, enthusiasm to Iowa as he barnstorms the state. And look, I think he's got a record to sell. He's got a record of winning, turning Florida from a toss-up state into a state that he won by 20 points. And I think he's going to outline his vision, his positive forward-looking vision, not just for Iowa, but for the rest of the country. And in terms of delivering results, there's nobody that's done it better than Governor DeSantis in terms of tax cuts, economic relief, standing with our men and women of law enforcement, and keeping this woke indoctrination out of our schools and out of the state of Florida. And I think he's got a record, and I think that's he's going to be very, very well received in Iowa.
Well, you talk about DeSantis and the woke ideology, which has become a little bit of his signature calling card at the moment. He was on Fox and Friends earlier this morning. Kevin, I want you to take a listen to what he said.
I think the military that I see is different from the military I served in. I see a lot of emphasis now on political ideologies, things like gender pronouns. I see a lot about things like DEI. And I think that that's caused recruiting to plummet. I think it's driven off a lot of warriors, and I think morale is low. So I think we really need to rejuvenate the morale in the military. So we will do that on day one.
And that will resonate with voters as we face so many challenges in an unstable world. So, Kevin, I ask you, obviously you guys, Democrats, have made very clear you would like to face Trump, but are you concerned about DeSantis?
Well, Griff, I think the president can beat anyone in the Republican field looking at what's going on the right bench. But listen, this is all eyes obviously will be on Iowa. This is make or break for President Trump. Of course, he came in second, as you remember, in 2016 to Ted Cruz, but he leads DeSantis by anywhere by between 20 and 25 points. And you're seeing indications that Donald Trump and his campaign are looking at more of kind of an on-the-ground, in-your-face, you know, you're reporting, Griff, from Iowa, that these voters like to see their candidates up close and personal in advance of that caucus. This is only the second visit of Governor DeSantis in recent months. Obviously, he's kicking it off his Iowa swing tomorrow in Des Moines. So again, it's that retail politics element, and we'll see, to your question, if those cultural issues like wokeism and things like that that the governor's made a big deal of in the Florida will come to bear in Iowa.
Yeah, so, Stephen, let me play for you. It's not clear that Democrats in Iowa, particularly young people, particularly want to see Biden as the top of the ticket. Take a listen to what some of the students told us.
I didn't see enough action in these past 4 years to deserve re-election at this point.
I think that we need more young people. And so I think that's really my biggest thing is I just think that it's, you know, having a president that old is just kind of unprecedented.
I think it's time for like a fresher face to come in and for him to support or be challenged by a younger Democratic candidate.
Stephen, I'll give you the last word.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, look, you've got somebody who's 80 years old who could be 82 when reelected. And that's why you're seeing his numbers are so soft. His approval rating is in the high 30s. And he's got soft support from not just the base, but from independents as well. It poses a significant challenge for him. I mean, this is, again, somebody that has a six-hour workday. I think the American voters deserve a full-time president, somebody who can bring the energy to that office.
Yeah.
Governor Ron DeSantis is in a really good spot moving forward.
Stephen, I said I'd give you the last word, but Kevin, in 10 seconds, you agree?
Listen, young people powered Joe Biden's election in 2020. He won young voters by 30% at near record numbers. They're going to show up in 2024, just as they did in 2020, to reelect this president.
It's on. Here comes Iowa. We're 526 days away from the election,
right.
And already it's heating up. Stephen, Kevin, thank you very much. Have a great Memorial
Day. Chris.